Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome. Viewers all over the world who are watching me through this channel, Specialist TV, sponsored by Specialist Foundation. I want to take this opportunity to thank this channel to be in the front line, to support the men of God, to spread the good news all over the world. So as you are tuning in, as you are watching, remember to share with a friend, remember to share with someone. And I know that God will bless you today. Today I have your message. And I know that God will lift you. God will bless you in Jesus' name. Before I start, my name is Pastor Japheth Titus. I'm born again. I love Jesus. He is my personal savior. And I thank him for his grace, because he has taken me from somewhere. I was nobody, but today I'm somebody because of his grace. So I'm so proud to serve my Lord Jesus Christ. So I minister in all nations, like church, Kenya, Nairobi. So welcome. Today I have just a good message to you, and a wonderful message to you. And I know after this chapter, God will bless you and you will be blessed. Today I want to talk about trusting. As I was coming here to studio, it's like God was talking to me. He was telling me, man, my servant, I'm so angry with my people, because nowadays when troubles come, they don't know where they can run to. They don't know where they can go. Others are trusting human beings. Others are trusting false prophets. Others are trusting their money, their wealth. Others putting their trust in the witchcraft or witch doctors. So that thing goes so furious with that. Then it's like he was telling me, when you are going to start to let my people know that where they can put their trust to. And that's why I'm here. I'm here to tell you, to talk to you, to know where you can put your trust to. I won't take much more time. I want you to take your Bible and to read with me in the book of Jeremiah. I'm using King James version. So Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 5. Downward to verse 8. And I know that God will bless you. Okay, I want to read. Thus says the Lord, cursed be the man that trusted in the man. That is God, your God, talking to you. Say, cursed be to man that trust or put your trust to man. Praise God. So, if you can see God is talking with you like this, then that is very sure that God is so angry with you. Why? Because you are sitting in the heaven and seeing where you are trusting, are flowing to. And that's why I'm here to tell you what God wants you to do today. And I know that God will bless you. That says the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. Hallelujah. And maketh flesh his arm. You trust in men for a help, which they can't help you. They can't offer to you. You are putting your trust, so much energy, to the wrong places. Why can't you sit or to take a moment and put your trust to the Lord? You are trusting your flesh. You can see today, you see that you are so much healthy. So it's like you don't need God. Because you have been trusting your body, you have been trusting your flesh so much than God. Then God says that, cursed be unto you. Praise God. And the whose heart departeth from Lord. So when you put your trust on people, or to put your trust on money, or you can put your trust in your flesh, then you make your heart depart from your Lord. You make your heart depart from, hallelujah, from the Lord Jesus. Remember whom to trust. David stood and said,
I put my eyes on the mountains. I put my eyes on the valleys where my help can come from. But he came to realize my help comes from the Lord, where I can put my trust on. Hallelujah. Other scriptures says that others trust in their chariots, others in their horses, but I will trust in the name of the Lord. Where are your trust? Where are you putting your trust? Ask yourself. You have been sitting there, you are sick, you are jobless, you don't know what to do, but God is talking to you today to trust in Him. Because if you can trust God, if God can tell you, okay, my son, my daughter, at the end of the day, I will give you a V8, I will give you a Range Rover, then God is faithful. He will give unto you. You are not the first one. God has been providing to so many. But if you can rely on me, even a bicycle, I can't provide my... So I am 100%. At the end of the day, you will be my enemy. Because I promise you something I can't deliver to you. But if you can trust in the Lord, even in the machinate, even in that job, God will give to you. Verses 6. For it shall be like the earth in the desert, and they shall not see when goods come. So you'll be, okay, earth is like dry grasses in the desert. They don't have hope because in the desert there is no water, there's no life there. So if there's no life, then it means that there's no hope. Praise God. So that man puts trust in men or in their something else. Then God is saying that they like that earth, that dry grasses. So why if you troubled yourself? But shall inhabit the purchased places in the wilderness, in a salt land and not inhabited. Blessed is the man. Hallelujah. Then the Lord saying, blessed is the man that trusted in the Lord. Hallelujah. That trusted in the Lord. Blessed is the man that puts the trust in the Lord. And the whose hope is in the Lord. Can you hear? Blessed is the man who puts his trust and the hope in the Lord. Where is your hope comes from? Where have you put in your trust? Then, if your trust is in the Lord Jesus Christ, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, that is his name, the creator of universe, our maker, the creator of earth and the heavens, then you are blessed. Blessed unto you who put your trust in the Lord. That you are watching me. Be blessed because you are putting your trust and hope to a living, what can I put it? To a living rock. Our Lord Jesus is where our hope and trust rely on. Nothing else we can run to. Remember the man of God, Daniel. Daniel could trust the Lord even if it came to a point that they will have to take his life, still he could remember and put the trust in the Lord. He could not change even a single mind. Praise God. Remember the story of Shadrach and Abednego. They could not change trusting their Lord because of difficulties, because of anything else. You are there, you don't have job, you don't have money to pay rent, you don't have anything. But you are saying it's like God have forsaken me, it's like there's no God. You don't have an idea. Our God is great. Our God is a miracle God. He's a wonder God. God will bless you and then God will lift you up. I want to check verse 8. And I know that God will bless you. For it shall be a tree planted by the waters or beside the waters. That's it. Hallelujah. You will be like a tree planted beside the waters. So there is no day you can come and say that you are dry. No, how? If you are planted just near the water, and you, if you read the Bible, in, I think it's Luke, Jesus saying that, I am the living water. I am the living water. Anyone who is thirsty, come in me and fetch the water, the living life. So you will be like a tree planted near the water. The water, Jesus. If Jesus will be near you, nothing will lack in Jesus' name. And that spreadeth out her roots by the rivers. So your roots will sprout just toward Jesus, where your hope is. Roots. I know you know the work of the roots. Just to capture. Eating water. Observing the raw materials of fertile rock. You know the work of the roots. I don't want to explain more. I know I'm talking with the learned people. So be blessed. But her leaf shall be green. Hallelujah. But her leaf shall be green. And they shall not be careful in the year of drought. Can you hear that? So, if you put your trust in Jesus, then when troubles come, you'll not be keen. Because you have the cover. You have everything you need in life. You'll not be so much observing or sensitive with the negative things. Because you are so firm with the Lord Jesus Christ. We are in verse 8. And I shall not be careful in the years of drought, neither shall cease from yielding fruits. Ceasing, yielding fruits. So you will bear fruits at your season. Because you are putting the you are putting your trust in the right place. So as you are watching me and you say, man of God, please pray with me. I see it's like my trust is not in the Lord. I've been trusting my husband. I've been trusting my wife. I've been trusting my child. I've been trusting my flesh. I've been trusting my money, my world. I've been trusting everything is surrounding me. Then you want from today to put your trust in the right place, and you are there. If you are not, if you don't, you are not even born again, and you say that, man of God, pray with me. So this is your time. Don't say I will be born again tomorrow, next time. What if Jesus will happen to come today? So you will go to hell. So don't miss this chance. And I know that God will bless you. So lift your hands and let us pray. So say these words after me and God will bless you. Say, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner. I have been putting my trust in the wrong places, in the wrong people, in my world. But from today, I have come to realize that only you where I can put my trust and hope. Rob my name the book of death and destruction, and write it new in the book of life. From today, help me to walk in your faith, to walk in your ways, and to obey your commands. In Jesus' name, I pray and I believe. Now you are born again. You can look around the church where they are preaching the true word of God, true gospel of Jesus Christ, and God will bless you. So